I'm going to show you how to take audio that sounds like this
and turn it into audio that sounds like this, all for free.
So the problem is you have great video, but the audio, not so great. Either it was recorded with the built-in mic of your device, or you just have a lot of background noise or echo, or maybe you even have a high quality recording, but you lost it. And then now all you have is the crappy one from your device. But now there's a free tool you can use to enhance any recorded speech, including really crappy ones, to studio quality. And it's called Adobe Podcast Enhance Speech. In this video, I'll show you one, how to use the tool, two, a few before and after tests to see how good of a job it does, and three, a few bonus tips to make this as quick and easy and painless as possible. Make sure you watch until the very end. Let's just jump right in. You'll want to navigate to podcast.adobe.com/enhance. Or just search for Adobe Enhance Speech in Google and it should be right at the top. That will take you to this very simple interface for Adobe Podcast Enhance Speech. All you need to do is drag and drop your audio or video here and it'll enhance up to 1 hour of audio at a time for free. And then once it's done processing, you'll be able to listen to the enhanced version and toggle it on and off so you can hear the difference. I'm gonna show you how to take audio that sounds like this
and turn it into audio that sounds like this.
You can also mix how much of the enhancement you actually want.
I'm gonna show you how to take audio that sounds like this and turn it into audio that sounds like this.
So then when you're ready and you've got the right mix that you want, just click the download button and then you'll get the enhanced version of the audio, which you can then drop right into your timeline under your video in your editor. It really is that easy and it's awesome that at the moment, this is completely free to use. All right, now for the fun part. Let's see how well this really works with some before and after examples in different environments you might find yourself in. For all of these, I'll be playing the enhanced speech at the default strength of 90%. So we're gonna be using my iPhone 12 for this. This is a slightly older phone and we're just gonna be using the built-in mic right on this device. So it's not gonna be the best quality audio and let's just start right here in this studio office. So we'll switch over to this camera and this microphone, and maybe the quality of this isn't terrible, but I wouldn't say it's the best. And so let's switch on enhanced speech.
All right, now I've switched on enhanced speech and it's definitely cleaned it up quite a bit. But again, this is gonna be like the best case scenario for an iPhone. You're sitting in a partially soundproof studio already. And yeah, so this isn't the best test. I say we should probably test this in noisier environments.
I'm currently in a parking garage and I don't know if you can tell, but there's quite a bit of reverb in here and a little bit of background noise as well.
And this is what it sounds like after I turn on enhanced speech. You can tell it's reduced a lot of that background noise and my voice is a lot easier to hear.
All right, I'm currently on a rooftop. It's a little bit of wind and a lot of background noise. No echo at all. So let's switch it on.
And this is what it sounds like after we've switched on enhanced speech. And you can tell that it has reduced a lot of that background noise. And it's not gonna be perfect, but I mean, it sounds pretty good. It's usable.
All right, I'm in a big empty stairwell. And there's a lot of reverb in this room. It's just a big room with all flat surfaces. So
this is what it sounds like when I turn on enhanced speech. You can tell it's reduced a lot of that reverb and my voice is much clearer.
All right, I'm recording this in a gym, quite a bit of echo in here.
And this is what it sounds like after you turn on enhanced speech. Much clearer, it has enhanced my voice quite a bit.
Now I'm outside on a nature trail. There's lots of birds, there's trees blowing in the wind, and you can also hear the crunching under my feet of the gravel.
And this is what it sounds like when you turn on enhanced speech. You can tell a lot of that background sound is pretty much eliminated and my voice is a lot clearer and easier to hear.
All right, so I'm now in a bathroom. This is like one of the worst places to be recording audio. It sounds absolutely terrible. I mean, there's a lot of echo, there's a lot of flat surfaces.
And this is what it sounds like after I turn on enhanced speech. You can tell a lot of that reverb is gone and my voice is much clearer.
I'm at the grocery store, definitely a lot of ambient noise. A lot of background sound.
And this is what it sounds like after we turn on the speech enhance. So you can tell it's definitely cut out a lot of those sounds.
All right, I'm sitting on a couch in a living room about 8 to 10 feet away from the microphone in the iPhone. And as you can hear, there's a lot of echo in this room. It's definitely not good quality audio.
And so this is what it sounds like when we turn on enhanced speech. So you can hear how much it's reduced that echo in the room and boosted up the quality of my voice. Currently, I'm standing next to a really busy intersection and there's a lot of noise from traffic. And this is what it sounds like when you turn on enhanced speech with all of this background traffic noise.
So we're back in the studio and I've switched back to the shotgun mic that I usually use, which is boomed right over my head right here. This is the Rode VideoMic Go 2 and it's about a $100 microphone and I really like it.
And this is what it sounds like taking the raw output from this mic and then using Adobe Enhanced Speech on it. Definitely a different sound to it. I'm not sure I like it as much as I like the more natural sounding audio from the mic.
So in my opinion, this tool is mostly useful for salvaging bad quality audio, not audio that sounds pretty good to begin with. Okay, so now I'm gonna speak really closely into the mic and we'll see how it does with Plosive P sounds and Sibilance S sounds. So this is without enhancement. She sells seashells by the seashore while Peter Piper picks a peck of pickled peppers. Okay, now we'll switch on speech enhance.
She sells seashells by the seashore while Peter Piper picks a peck of pickled peppers.
So yeah, it's not gonna do a perfect job, but it's definitely cleaning a lot of those plosive P sounds and those harsh S sounds up. By the way, if you're getting value out of this video, hit like, subscribe, and tap the notification bell so you can get more valuable content like this. Now, very important, if you're uploading a video to this tool, it's gonna take a lot longer using a video than if you just use only the audio. And you'll be limited on the file size. The last I checked, it was a 1 gig limit. Audio files are a lot smaller and therefore quicker to upload than a full video with the audio. So let me show you how you can extract just the audio from your video as a separate file to speed up how quickly this goes. I'll show you two main methods. So option one, if you have Adobe Creative Cloud already, it is super easy. You can just drop your file into Adobe Media Encoder, select waveform audio, and then click the start cue play button here, and it'll extract the raw audio as a .wav file for you right next to the video file. And then you can just drop that wav file into enhanced speech. They made this really easy, so you can just actually drop multiple files in here and do them all at once if you want. It's really, really convenient. And then there's option two. Of course, there's a totally free option, and that is to just download the free and open source VLC media player. There's a link below. And then use that to extract your audio. So after you install VLC, just open it up, click the file menu, convert/stream, and then you're gonna wanna drop your video into this box or use the file chooser, and then pick audio MP3 as the profile, and then choose the file you wanna save it as, and then click save. And after a moment, you'll have your audio converted and saved as an MP3 file. Converting to an audio file will make that upload go a lot faster than uploading a super large video file. So make sure you do this if you're gonna be using this tool. Now, if this video helped you and you want to totally level up your tools and resources for making videos, you're definitely gonna wanna check out this video next. I really hope this video helped you in a really big way, and thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.